अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू ऑल विल बी इन गुड हेल्थ। आई एम योर साइंस टीचर ऑफ ग्रेड 3। स्टूडेंट्स, ओपन योर बुक पेज नंबर 12। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अवर न्यू यूनिट, यूनिट 2, फूड एंड फीडिंग। व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय फूड? फूड आर एक्चुअली ईटेबल आइटम्स। यू कैन ऑल्सो से दैट एनीथिंग दैट नरिशिंग यू, दैट गिव अस एनर्जी। एंड फीडिंग, feeding means an instant of giving food. Feeding means an instant of giving food. In this unit we will study about food and feeding habits of different animals. Come to the next page, page number 13. Start from a first line. Every time you do something, run, jump, you need energy. When you do something, you need energy. Similarly, all living things need energy, which they get from food. Now, all living things need energy. Energy is actually ability to do work. So, all living things need energy, which they get from food. Energy is also required by living things to grow. Now, this energy also helps in growth of a living thing. Not all living things eat the same food. Green plants can make their own food in the sunlight, but animals cannot make their own food. Now, green plants also come in living things, but not all living things eat the same food. For example, green plants can make their own food in the sunlight, but animals cannot make their own food. Different animals have different diets, and we can put them into groups, classify them accordingly. What do you mean by classify? Arrange things according to shared characteristic. When you arrange something according to their characteristic. Now, different animals have different diets. We can put them into different groups, into the same groups, and classify them. Remember and understand what happens if you do not get enough energy from food. If we do not get enough energy from food, what will happen? We become weak and we cannot do activities. We cannot run. We cannot jump. If we not get enough energy from food, we cannot perform our activities. We become weak. Look at the picture. Here are some pictures. A meat eater, a grass and leaf eater, a fruit and nut eater. Look at the teeth. The teeth is different from each other. It's a teeth of meat eater. It's a teeth of grass and leaf eater. It's a teeth of fruit and nut eater. First group is omnivores. What do you mean by omnivores? Omnivores are actually those animals which can eat animals as well. Those animals which can eat animals, both animals and plants. Which can eat both animals and plants. For example, we human beings, we can also eat animals as well as plants. Human beings and some other animals eat both plants and animals. They are called omnivores. Hens and many birds like crows are omnivores. These are omnivores. For example, hens can also eat insects. They can also eat corns, etc. And many birds like crows, they can also eat corns, etc. Or plants eating animal as well as animals eating animal. Now, those animals which can eat plants as well as meat or flesh of other animals is known as omnivores. It's a picture of human teeth. Come to the next page, page number 14. Next topic is carnivores. Now, what do you mean by carnivores? Carnivores, animals that eat the meat of other animals. Animals that eat the meat of other animals are called carnivores. Lion, tigers, dogs and cats are carnivores. Here are pictures of carnivores. Now, those animals which eat the flesh of other animals or the meat of other animals are known as carnivores. Third one is herbivores. Herbivores, as the name indicates, that it's a plant-eating animal. Some animals eat plants. They are called herbivores. Cows, horses, rabbit and sheep are herbivores. Here are some examples of herbivores, that is cows, horses, rabbits and sheep are herbivores. Again, I summarize the topic. We study about omnivores, carnivores and herbivores. Omnivores are those animals which can eat plants as well as they can eat meat of other animals. Second is carnivores. Carnivores are those animals which can eat meat of other animals. Third one is herbivores. Herbivores are plants eating animals. Those animals which eat plants. It's enough for today. Thank you, students. Have a nice day.